Acdsee Photo Studio Ultimate 2023 has a lot of functions, a lot of features. Keep in mind that Acdsee did send me a code to try this out and make the video on. They added AI-based face adjustments, face enhancements, so easy retouching of faces with this feature. They simplified the photo merging, doing panoramas and things like that. You can quickly select out sky or subjects from images. They enhance being able to select objects with a new shape selection tool. Improved on the search capabilities, non-destructive raw editing as usual. Keep in mind that they do have different versions of this. This is the ultimate version that I'll be showing you. First off, just looking at the management tab, sort by a lot of different options. Let's group by camera. When I group by camera, you can see so many different cameras here. I can click on one of these and jump to that specific camera. Let's say you're on a photo shoot. You had two different cameras of different models, makes sort them if you put all the images in one area. Reads a good amount of images. Of course, with newer cameras, they might be a little bit slower than other companies. But at the moment, all of my cameras are fully readable in Acdsee. And a lot of what I do is I organize, I adjust settings. So you can put ratings, you can put colors, and you can also filter by those ratings and colors, obviously. Just green, for example. Another feature that I use a lot of the time is comparison of images. So up here, go to Tools, Compare Images, zoom in, you can move them at the same time. You can lock or unlock images. Also view additional information if I want the histogram going or some metadata. We have a bunch of different tasks, the different tabs, media. Allows you to quickly browse through images. And this is one of the changes that they did. Select a group and I can add some metadata to it. So I'm a person and a man. Click that and those are set. Click one of these off and then I click back on it. You can see that the people man is set on there. View is a tab that I use quite often because it's a quick way of going through your images. You can zoom in very quickly and judge a photo's capabilities, and I can add a rating if I want. And if you press F on the keyboard, you can do a full zoom in. And the develop tab is something I use very often to adjust images without changing them. You have a ton of ways to adjust them in Acdsee. I need a new computer, it's getting slow. Example, exposure, highlights, whatever you want. Go into the detail tab, click on that. You can adjust sharpening amount. You can adjust the noise in the image, or noise cancellation, I should say. And here's a skin smoothing effect. It's a little difficult to see, but it is definitely adjusting my face. All of this information will be saved as a sidecar file or into their database. Here's the edit tab. On the side here, we have all of these AI-based one-click operations. Remove background. Try that out. It's not gonna be perfect. You can edit that as you need, but it's a one-click thing. There isn't any adjustment to it. So I'm gonna control Z on there. You can also select subject. This one gives you a bit more options because it just creates a selection. You can adjust this as needed with your selection tools. So if I wanted to remove some of this additional stuff, I can do that. Shape selection tool, which is the new one. I already have a selection going, but I can do this one. See that it is starting to build itself. I don't have to be especially accurate as far as I understand it. So once we have a full circle with a double click, I can go back and adjust each connection point. And you can see it's not straight, which gives you some fine grain control. Up here, commit. So that just basically added to our selection. I have found that Acdsee does need quite a beefy computer. My computer is a i7-6700, so not the best. And then we can go into this AI face edit feature. So I found the face, it zoomed in on it. And then if we click this edit AI points, we can see that it didn't do quite what it needed to with the mouth, so I can adjust that if I want. Face, eyebrows, nose, mouth, makeup. So face width. There we go. Obviously a lot's not gonna work out too well, but subtle changes, I'm sure, if I want to look like that big meme chin guy, super buff chin guy, potentially get there. Although my chin is not nearly. And I add the sharpening. You can see that does actually do something. That could be useful. If I want the eyes a little bit lighter, that's a good option. So this one here, I noticed it doesn't work properly with glasses. I'll have to try that out at some point with someone that doesn't have glasses. It seems to work pretty well, considering. If I hold the Z key down, you can see what the adjustments actually did here. Got those anime eyes going. The skin tune from the develop tab is in here as well. This is something that I'd use more. See, it's just a very basic skin softening feature on a slider. I use this a lot, and the glow is there as well. So very subtle. Well, maybe not as subtle as you can see. It's definitely working with that much applied. Select sky from this image. Now it might know that this is water, but it's frozen water, so it didn't notice. For example, if I wanted to make it darker or lighter, pressed exposure, I can do that. And if it's not perfect, you can still go in there and change the selection, as I showed. One thing that I often do is remove backgrounds from product images, and then I use them in my thumbnails for videos. So let's try remove background, see what happens. One click operation. Zoom in and see how it did. That looks decent. Okay. So it didn't get this hidden area, but I could go in there and erase it. Now there are a few features this has to quickly do tasks that usually take quite a few steps. In this case, HDR images. I already did process a few, but I'll give you an example. So I have a bunch of images with a bracket, which basically means different exposure of the same scene. You'd select what you want here. So I'll take all of them in this case and go into process HDR. Pretty sure they revise this for 2023. Once this pops up, you have options to decide what you want. Black and white, detailed, dramatic, and natural. So I'm going to put it into an HDR folder. I'm going to use TIFF, so that should hold a lot of information. Here it is with the, I think it was 5 different images. Definitely HDR. Let's take a look at the... So some of this is related to the lens. I was using the kit lens, which is not the best optically. And I probably could have removed aberrations before doing that, but you can see a lot of detail in here. I did also do a few other ones here. This is M50. Again, some lens issues here. That was a kit lens as well. And there's information in this bright area compared to the dark shadow area. Here's one other photo. Ton of sky detail and a lot of foreground as well. Also image stacking, focus stacking in this case. So first off, let's take a look at the sample images. I use this in one of my previous ACDC videos, these specific images. So I have a huge set of this one, and then I just have 3 images for these other 2 examples. Go into the process menu and use focus stack. It's also in photo merge as well. Again, there could be some optical related issues, or it's just how they process, but you can see some haloing on the text. However, it did pull in the sharp text, so I could potentially see using this, but there are some optical issues, at least with my set of photo, examples. Here, we do see detail in the front as well as in the back. That was a 3 image test. This one is a ton of images. Again, we see detail in the back, SD card, and in the front. So it works. It's very quick. So if you're looking for a convenient way to stack with not a ton of flexibility, it's an option. Panorama type things are just photo merging. I processed 2 examples, so you can see this one, quite a few images. And then this one, in this case, you go into process, photo merge, select your images, panorama. you let it go through its thing. You can maybe do remove vignette. And yeah, but I already went through those. This one had a ton of images. When I took these photos, I focused once, I turned off the focus, and I kept the settings fully manual. So the focus was most likely right in the center. Then I just tried to move the camera around without moving it too much. But with so much going on here, there is some artifacting. Well, like right here is a little quirk going on. I think I missed one of the photos that I should have had in here, but a little bit better this time. Could potentially see that using that or just using it as a normal panorama thing. Okay, besides that, we also have a people tab. Click on that. I don't have any named ones at the moment, and I only let it process my images, but you can see it's already finding faces in this case. Okay, right click, rename. So that's me. Friend one. It did find a face. Quite a few other. So that's not a face. You can delete that one. Yeah. Take that out of the database. These are toys, obviously. But wow, it's getting side profiles, getting background face. I specifically put a few little unique images of myself in there. So there is a lot of power and functionality once you start naming and grouping faces. Then you can search on a person and go into named faces. Now I can see the different ones I've been adding. So then if I do multiple photo shoots with her, I would be able to quickly find those and go through them. And there's also a dashboard, which I've shown before. I have very few images in here, but you can see 700 something just for this video. Favorite resolution is a cool little feature. They don't do a ton with this, but it's a nice, fun little thing. So even just in this set of example images, you can see some ISO data, preferences, different cameras used. Yeah. So imagine if you have your full, huge data set of different photos, then you would have a lot more interesting information. One thing I do often is add EXIF information to file names so that when I use them in the video editor, I can just copy paste that information very quickly. So I have a few images selected here. Go into edit, rename, or press F2 on the keyboard, and then pull in some EXIF information. One star will add the original name down here, or use the hash or a sequence. So I have those selected, I have them adjusted. I can go in here and add a little bit extra to make it look proper. That looks pretty good. Click rename. So now those are all good to go. They did adjust the quick search functionality. It's going to pull the different apertures that I set to the file name, but F8 and then any F dot full search. If you want to search on EXIF information, forgetting the quick search, here we can go into the weeds. Let's do ISO and model. Click OK. Now we have these different fields. Let's do ISO 100, the classic, and Canon. There should be different cameras. The start. Okay, that was quick. So in this case, let me group by camera. Let's see what we pulled in here. Got the 30D, the M100, M5, is less than or equal. So let's do equal again, 32. Okay, that worked. So I can see a lot of capabilities here with this advanced search. And you can save them, which was nice. Acdsee Photo Studio Ultimate 2023. I mostly use it for the managing of photos, processing, doing develop where it's non-destructive, but it does have a lot of the edit capabilities with the AI stuff and everything that's new to it. I'm really excited for the search capabilities in the manage area that have been improved. So I'm just showing them here, but I'm getting used to it myself. Yeah, a lot to it. Again, keep in mind they sent me this code to try out and make the video on. It's Scott Photography Banzai, thanks.